Hey, that clown looks like a dinosaur.
Ooh, there's a cat.
That one looks like a tornado.
Oh, you kids and your cloud watching. That's all well and good, but have either of you ever actually made a cloud?
No way.
No one can make a cloud.
Sure you can. I'll show you. You can check it out here at the University of Washington Department of Atmospheric Sciences outreach page.
Welcome to Kitchen Laboratory. Today's chefs will be preparing cloud to be judged by our cloud connoisseur.
Our secret ingredient today is most refreshing on a hot day. It naturally appears as a solid, gas, and liquid, and covers about 70% of the Earth's surface. The ingredient is...
sausage?
Water! Chefs, you may begin now.
So let's talk clouds.
Good idea.
Clouds are made of tiny droplets of liquid water or tiny ice crystals suspended in the air. Now water in its gas form, or water vapor, is naturally in the air wherever you go. When there's a lot of it, we say the air is very humid. Clouds appear when water vapor changes into liquid water in the air.
Clouds are tiny drops of water. Fascinating. How do we get the vapor into a liquid?
Water vapor changes into a liquid, or condenses, when humid air gets colder.
Brr.
That's right. That cooling often happens when air rises in the sky.
Also, condensation is easier if the water has something to stick to, such as a window, a cup, or tiny particles. Clouds form when water vapor condenses onto tiny particles in the air.
It looks like our chefs are ready to start cooking, and the action in the kitchen is heating up.
And that humid air is cooling down.
Chef Alto jumps right in with the secret ingredient, placing an ample serving in a beautiful crystal carboy. And what's this? A match. Very clever.
What's that match for, Finn Dyson?
Good question, Bergeron. That match is going to provide the tiny particles for cloud droplets to form on.
And add a bold, smoky flavor.
We can see here that the chef is pumping air into the bottle now. The pressure in the bottle is going up with every pump. When the pressure goes up, the air warms up.
Looks like the chef's getting hot too with all that pumping.
Looks like she's just about wrapped up. Let's see what she has in store for the presentation.
I have to say, Finn Dyson, the presentation so far hasn't thrilled me.
Oh, my eye!
Great finish. How did you manage to pull off this amazing cloud? What was going through your head at the end there?
Well, Finn Dyson, when I pulled the cork, the pressure dropped like a rock. And when the pressure dropped, the temperature dropped.
Drop it till it's cold.
Yeah, so you know how when you let the air out of a bike tire, it gets cold? Well, it's just like that here. All you need to form a cloud is water vapor and cooling.
Wow, brilliant. Thank you, Chef Alta. Now let's see what Chef Strato has in store for us.
Looks like Chef Strato isn't going to be making any clouds today. There hasn't been anything happening on that side of the kitchen.
Astonishing! How did you pull off this amazing comeback?
It's all about water vapor and cooling, Finn Dyson. You get the water vapor from the water in the bowl, you get the cooling from the dry ice.
Hey, wait a minute. That's no cloud. That's just the carbon dioxide you're seeing.
Actually, the carbon dioxide gas is invisible. So this is just a regular cloud made of tiny water droplets. It's like when you exhale on a really cold day and you see your breath. That moist air that you breathe out cools down and condensation occurs.
Well, there you have it, folks. Two different ways of cooling down air to cause condensation and form those tiny water droplets that make clouds so beautiful and delicious.
Wow, that's some pretty amazing stuff.
Hey, that cloud looks like a cloud in a bottle.
The dry ice cloud looks nice, but it's far too bland for my palate. The cloud in a bottle has a rich, smoky flavor and a delightful aroma. It went out with a bang.